Hey friends! We look how to plot one of the most important charts of supply chain management, the Pareto chart. To remind you the context, I have made a video and published an article on how to use the Pareto principle to optimize the layout of your warehouse. In your portfolio of products, most of the time you'll have a minority of products that will bring the majority of revenue or volumes. This is the Pareto effect, also called the 80-20 rule. When you design the layout of your warehouse, you need to consider this. Therefore, you need a chart. This chart is showing on the x-axis the percentage of SKU and on the y-axis the percentage of volumes ordered in boxes. To get quick insights, you usually add a vertical line at the x-axis coordinate 20% and a horizontal line at the y-axis coordinate 80%. So you can compare your volume split versus the 80-20 rule. Let's see how we can build this chart using Python. So, let's start. So, like each time, we have to start by importing the different libraries. So, the first visuals that I will share in this series are very simple. So, most of them, you can only plot them with Matplotlib and you need pandas to manipulate the data frame. Here, I just add some visual settings. So, number of columns to show, number of items to display. Here's to wrap the data frame, so it's more aesthetic. And then I start to import, so 1 month of older data. So one line is one other line, and we have like 140,000 other lines. As you can see, you have the order number. So for instance, in this order, you have two lines. In two lines, you have two SKUs that are picking quantity of one. So the first step to prepare your Pareto chart is to group the quantities by box. So, group by box. So I will create a specific data frame that we'll call DFPAR or Pareto. I will group by SKU and I will take the sum of the box and I will call the column box or just box. Then I didn't need to create this because it was already naming like this. Anyhow, then we need to sort. So to create the Pareto chart, what we are going to do, we are going to index each row and now we are going to sort by descending order. So the highest rotation at the beginning, the lowest at the end. Then we are just going to rank the different rows. And then we are going to divide this rank by the total number of SKUs. And then we have the x-axis. And the y-axis, we are going to divide the cumulative sum by the total. So it's very easy. So we start by sorting. So we sort by box. Ascending is false. And we want to keep it. Then we reset the index because we are going to set our own index. We calculate the cumulative sum. So here it would be to define your y-axis box, and I use the function cumulative sum. Then I will take the percentage. Here, so I will just multiply by 100 and divide by the total. White box. Okay. So now we have our y-axis. So then for the x-axis, what we need is to count the number of SKUs that you are accumulating at the line n. Remember, we have reset the index, so it's quite easy. The job is already done. Percentage SKU. So I'll call it percentage SKU. Again, so here I will take the index. I will add one because it's starting at zero. And I will be smart and put that between brackets. I will make it as a float. So I can divide it. Let me check. I think yeah, we're good here. And then I will just divide by the total index max plus one. Actually, I could have also take the length of the. So now we have our Pareto chart that is already ready because we have our x-axis, which is the cumulative number of SKUs, and the y-axis, which is the cumulative sum by percentage. But what we want to do is to compare the distribution of our portfolio with the 80-20 rule. So we need to add some marks on the chart to basically compare it with the 80-20 rule. So what we need is x. We need the coordinate x equals 20% with the coordinate y equals 80%. So we are going to define both. And then we are going to draw horizontal and vertical lines. So first, 80% of the volume, which is supposed to correspond to 20% of the SKUs, but we will see it will not. So for this first, I filter the data frame, only taking the values higher than 80% for the volume. Because here, I'm not sure that there is a coordinate with the cumulative sum at 80%. So I want to take the closest, and I will take the closest from the top. Percentage can sum, take higher, and then copy. And then what I'm going to do is first to take the x, so the first coordinate on the x-axis. So here, I'll take this, 80%, I think it's percentage of SKUs, and I will take the minimum. I will do the same for the sum. So here the sum, it will not be exactly 80%, it will maybe 80.5 or 81 depending on the granularity of your distribution, but it will be a good approximation. Then I want to do the same for the number of SKUs. So here it will be 20%, here it will be SKU, so here it would be the SKU 20 beam. So here it not be SKU, and I will do the same. I will take higher than 20%. Actually, I could have include 20%, but yeah, let's do this. So I don't think we will have. Yeah, so here, let me just rename. Terms of 20. So here, I just need to change, so here is SKU 20, and I take the minimum, so we're good, here SKU 20, I take the minimum, and then it's not, okay, I think we're good, and then sometimes, you know, we have also the ABC segmentation, and the A that are the very high rotations. are supposed to make 5% of the volume. So we can do the same. So 5% of the SKUs, sorry. So we can also look at what happened if we have 5%. Boom, boom, boom. 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 Okay. I think we're good. No, we're not. Because here it's higher than 5%. I think we're good. Yeah, we can plot. I mean, we can we can look at it. And after this, I think we should be good. Yeah, but of course it's not par. I think, yeah. Then we can start to plot. So it's a normal plot, nothing special. Let's first start by plotting. Then after, we are going to, so on the x-axis is the SKU. Then we add the percentage of the cumulative sum. Of course, here it's not SKU, but it's percentage of SKUs. The Y, it's not a capital Y. Add the figure size. So here, I think it should be good, if I remember well. The color, I like tap blue. I don't want legend. And I like thick lines. I mean, it makes things a bit more clear. I think we're good here. What we need to add is the labels. So here, the percentage of SKU. The font size should be 14. I do the same for the Y label. Boxes, yeah, I think we're good. I add the title. PLT not title. Pareto analysis by box quantity. Up font size 40. Actually, yeah, we can show. Okay, looks good. But now we need, you know, it's a bit difficult. So here, 20%, where are we? We are a bit higher than 80. It's not even very clear. So let's add our lines. So first, start with 5% SKUs, the very, very high rotations. So here, you have a function in matplotlib to add an horizontal line. So I think it's axe-ish line. Oh, I forgot. I hope it's this. Here you take the percentage of, so it's a horizontal line, so you need to show the y-axis coordinate, which is the percentage of, represented by 5% of the SKU. So this is perk 5, sum 5. Yeah, we're good. The color, yeah, red. Yeah, the line style, so we take dotted line. And width can put 3. Oh no, let's put 2. Okay, so we have the horizontal line. We do the same with the vertical line. So here the vertical line, so it corresponds to the value, the total cumulative sum of the represented by 5% of the top SKU. So it will be, let me check. No, it's the vertical line. So here is the x-axis. So it's the number of SKUs. So it's 5% actually. But it's not exactly 5% because as I told you, it depends on the granularity. So we take the closest to 5%. 80% of the volume. Here, it's the same. We can copy paste. Up. But here on the y-axis, so the horizontal line is the 80% of the volume. So the 80% of the volume is him. No, it's him. And we can put it at orange. Here also orange. The vertical line. So here the vertical line, it will be the coordinate that is representing, that is linked to 80% of the volume, which is supposed to be 20%, but we'll see it will not, it's not exactly this. So it's number of SKUs that represent 80% of the volume. Okay, we could. Okay, let me check. I will copy that with the 20% volume. So here's the same. A little tweak. We just need to change 20, 20, orange. How we put green? Yeah. I think we get no mistakes. Boom. So here, the 5%, making a bit more than 65% of your SKUs. Here, the orange one. The orange one is the 80% of the volume, and we can see here that it's less than 20%. So you have very, very high rotation. And if we look at the 20%, yeah, it's something close to 85. So here, like very, very quickly, you can understand the distribution of your different reference. And what we can see here is that you have very high rotations, so you need to put a little focus on them for inventory management, but also you need to optimize your layout to improve the picking productivity for them and the replenishment. I hope it was clear enough. If you have any question, feel free to let them in the comment section.